So let's put all of the pieces together, whether it's the intake that we've talked about in the last video that we did through research and sourcing competitive intelligence and the whole idea of unlocking somebody's best performance. So Caitlin and Melissa, thank you again for joining me. Let's talk about the whole big picture and how we tie all those together.
Sure. I mean, big picture.
That's a lot there.
I know there's a ton there.
Yeah. That's why I'm setting it up like that.
Well, when you ask people too, can you think of the big picture? Usually people are just naturally thinking of what's in front of them, right? What do I need to accomplish? How do I do that today, right? And they're not thinking long-term. So for us, you know, working with everything that we do from the start of research all the way through in our developmental products and things like that, there's a lot of options that I think a lot of clients don't consider because they're just thinking of the initial need right off the bat. Oh my gosh, I need candidate names, you know?
So research is really in getting that list of names for those that aren't completely aware of what that is.
Yeah, exactly. Which is great. And it provides a lot of, you know, a lot of information and great data to clients, right? But then a lot of times, what do they do with that data? You know?
Yeah, so I have a list of names. I have a bunch of phone numbers. I have email addresses. I have entire organizational structures. Yeah. But then it's a very expensive paperweight that I set on my desk and put your coffee cup on it, and it sits there on my desk.
Yeah. And Caitlin could probably talk to that in terms of the sales, right? So after we do a research project, she's usually the one connecting again with the client, and that's probably, she hears that a lot more than I do.
So do you guys have a lot of clients that'll start with, okay, I got the names, realize, oh my gosh, I can't do anything with it, and then come back and say, can you do more?
Yeah, I mean, just this morning, we had a client that we did the research for, and we got about halfway through, and she's like, well, could you start reaching out and kind of giving me a feel for what people are saying? So we did that, and we kind of came back around, grouped around after the holidays today, and she's like, honestly, I think I just need you guys to like do the full cycle recruiting on it, because I don't have time, and these people, we're talking doctors and you know scientists, they take a while to get a hold of, and so they could see the value in the fact, great, this is great data. These are people that would fill this role functionally, but now we need you to help us with the outreach and the candidate development.
So as somebody goes along that journey, if they just need name gen or if they just need that initial call, as some people call sourcing or recruiting, is that the same person doing all of that? Or does everybody have an expertise to be able to help the client through those?
Yeah, everybody has an expertise. The one nice thing is we do work collectively together. So if we need to go back to research at some point after we've been calling candidates and we're finding, oh boy, we're getting a lot of no's, or we need to revamp based on the data that we're finding out when we're talking to folks, we go right back to research, engage them back. So I think that is a big difference of us working collectively. We all have our expertise and levels of service that we provide, but working together as a group for the end goal for that client, I think is huge.
So Qualigence has not only these three different services, but we have a different kind of model of charging our clients too. What's the advantage that clients are getting out of that hourly model from your perspective, Caitlin?
One thing that we hear time and time again is they're so used to just 20, 25, 30% of the salary, and they're like, that's so much money, right? And with our hourly model, we're able to only charge them for the level of service that they need. So if they're going to research, that's all they're getting charged for. And then when it turns to recruiting, they're getting charged the recruiting rate. So they're able to, a lot of times, come in much, much less than that 20, 25, 30%.
In my experience, if you go back to the last video that the three of us did together, we were talking about the importance of intake sessions.
Yeah.
Who wants to spend, if I'm a contingent recruiter, who wants to spend the time doing a really detailed intake session, because it may narrow down the list of potential candidates. But for us, that actually drives our business as opposed to the opposite. I mean, have you had that conversation with clients?
Yeah, because I think, you know, to Caitlin's point, a lot of clients are used to a certain rate that you're being charged just no matter what. But with that comes, hey, I'm going to throw over 10 resumes. You mind taking a look? And there could be some in there that are a good fit. We don't know.
So who's the expert now?
Yeah, exactly. And then they're choosing from 10, whereas really, you know, I've told, Caitlin's heard me tell clients all the time that the folks that we're sending over, they are ready to go to that hiring manager. They have been fully developed, hitting the marks that we talked about on that full intake session. So the next step should be right to that hiring manager versus, you know, going to that person and then another person and maybe seeing if they're a fit just based on, because we're looking outside the skill set.
Sure.
You know?
So our tagline, we talk about helping clients not only hire the right individuals, but unlock their performance. Mm-hmm. Tell me about that. What does that really mean?
I think it's getting to know the person past the resume.
How right? do we do that?
I think we have the tools like the predictive index or perception predict to understand who they are, right? Like the drivers behind them or what kind of success we can look at them for and depend on them for when we bring them in. And so it's great. Their resume could be awesome and that doesn't make them a great performer and vice versa, right? Not everyone's skilled in resume writing. Yeah. So a lot of times you have really great people and the resume is just not awesome, doesn't pop out. So
and really crappy people with great resumes who paid for that great
yeah.
resume.
Yeah, yeah. exactly. We see it all the time. So
well, one of the other interesting things that you talk about with perception predict is often the things that we're looking for, there's actually no correlation to the success of the actual candidate. Mm-hmm. Right? It's interesting. So tools like that give us the data to determine, are what we're looking for the right things?
Yep.
And then once they're actually in there, how do they interact with the rest of the team? What's been your experience in terms of the success of clients using data to make decisions and ultimately try to get that best performance?
They're really looking at the full picture, right? They're looking at the career of that person versus I need to fill this spot just right now. You know, they're looking at, is this person a long-term fit for me? So the ones that do utilize those things in the right way, it shows that they're looking forward for those future things and really investing in that new person that's coming into that position.
How important, Caitlin, is it to kind of tie those pieces together?
I mean, I think it's really important. I think it looks at things like how long can you expect them to stay with you and how, you know, do you maybe have a gap right now as far as somebody that's driving or successful in your team that maybe this person could help fill or vice versa? Are they going to maybe not be the strongest person? You're not just looking at, to Melissa's point, what they've done in the last 5 or 10 years, but you're what companies they've worked for, but you can understand who they are with a little bit more insight. Even things, it can help you understand how to train them to get the best out of them.
We know if you're watching this, you've probably felt the pain of hiring somebody that you thought was perfect and on paper and skill set, they were absolutely perfect. Mm-hmm. But in 6 months, they either leave or they get fired and they were a top performer where they came from. Mm-hmm. But all of a sudden, they're no longer a top performer.
Yeah.
We try to avoid that by the versatility of the services that we have and trying to save the client money at the same time.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, thank you again for your thoughts on that and your input. You know, at Qualigence, we're all about people living their purpose. That's why we provide all of these different services to help you identify the right person and unlock their performance. And make sure you click on the notification bell to sign up for our weekly video series. And make sure you click down below. That's our link. You'll learn more about all the services that Melissa's team and Caitlin's team can provide you to help you find that right person and unlock the performance. See you next week.